Hey everyone, welcome back to Go Local Live. I am Ava Gaudette, and up next in the Navigant Credit Union Broadcast Center, I have here Dr. Edward Markward, as we call Ed.
Yes, please.
He has served as music director and conductor for the Rhode Island Civic Chorale and Orchestra for over 30 years, and this holiday season they are going to be presenting Rhode Island's only complete version of Handel's Messiah, and I'm very excited to talk to you about it.
Well, I'm very happy to be here. I've never done one of these where I could watch pedestrians
walk by, cars, dogs, everything.
Right.
Yep.
Before I forget, happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you so much. You as well. I know we're getting definitely in the holiday spirit here. And Messiah is very traditionally a kind of Christmas sort of piece. Everyone sort of relates it to Christmas time.
It certainly is in this country. It was originally written for Easter, as a matter of fact. But in this country, the United States, we generally perform it at Christmas, and we like to be the first out of the box. Mm. So the Saturday and Sunday after Thanksgiving is our traditional kickoff to the holiday season, and we're starting with a bang doing the entire work, which is about 2.5 hours, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, I find it interesting because as Rhode Island's only complete version, that means to me other people may be only doing portion of it, which the Hallelujah Chorus, of course, is the most famous portion of this
piece. I threaten to cut it every year, but I never do. Right. I mean, there are a lot of choirs who do parts of it, and as they should. And then there are some who do maybe 2/3 of it, and that's good, too. But we feel that we should do it all. And in the 61 years of the chorale's existence, it is performed at over 50 times.
Wow.
We try to do it every other year.
Yeah. And what are some of the challenges to doing the entire piece?
Stamina for the chorus, mostly standing up that long.
2.5 hours.
And then this time, of course, we do it Saturday night. And then they have to repeat it on Sunday. So it's almost 5 hours of standing.
Wow.
We used to do it at Veterans Auditorium, and we had chairs, but we don't now. At the cathedral, it's a long stand.
Yeah, yeah, it is, as you said, a lot of stamina involved. And of course, as the conductor, you are able to sort of give your interpretation of this piece. What do you feel is your sort of stamp or your creative input in this?
That's a really good question, and if we had some of my choristers here, they would tell you I don't have one because I change it every time we do it. As a matter of fact, there was a board member a couple of years ago when we were about to do it in the fall, and she said, "I just can't wait," and this is with sarcasm dripping, "I can't wait to see what changes you've made this year," because that means they have to change as well. So does the orchestra, and I always mark the orchestra parts, so they have a little bit of a leg up on it,
mm-hmm,
too.
Mm-hmm.
That one of the challenges is some of the players, they're all professional, and many are from the Rhode Island Philharmonic, so many will play it 2 weeks down the road with the Philharmonic as well. And then they will go off and play it in Worcester, and maybe Dedham, and someplace else. And I'm glad we're first, because they could get saturated pretty well with Messiah.
Absolutely, yeah, you have some
as
fresh...
As great a work as it is, you know, you wouldn't listen to it all day, every day.
Exactly, exactly. And now, the Messiah is obviously a very traditional piece, but at the Rhode Island Civic Chorale and Orchestra, you also handle a lot of contemporary pieces. So how do you feel... Is your approach different to conducting such a traditional piece as opposed to conducting a work that maybe not many people have heard before?
Not so you would notice or the audience would notice, I don't think. Each piece, whether it's new or old, has its specific challenges. As a matter of fact, we did a world premiere last season and we're fortunate to be able to do another one this season, both by local composers, incidentally. And so what one tries to convey is what the composer's wishes are, whether it's Beethoven, or in this case, Jeffrey Gibbs from the University of Rhode Island, or Roger Sishi, who lives in Scituate, or Handel. As a conductor, you try to study a score well enough and thorough enough to know that we're giving what we think the composer would ask for.
Right. Well, obviously, as I said, the Hallelujah Chorus is the most famous part of this piece, but are there other moments within this piece that for you as the conductor are particularly exciting or?
Well, yeah, there are, well, almost every one presents, since every movement is roughly 2 to 3 minutes long, the mood sort of changes with the movement. And the work is divided into three parts, roughly. Prophecy and birth, then the passion and resurrection, and then the revelation toward the end. The last part is three parts. And they're filled with arias, some of which are thrilling, some of which are consoling, choruses which are exciting, some of which are passionate, and then the overture itself that only the orchestra plays. And there's a little pastoral symphony of about 35 seconds in the middle of it that is very touching as well. So there's a lot of things going on, and each presents its own little moment in the sun, if you will.
It sounds beautiful, and I know for myself, I can only speak for myself, but I'm sure for many people, just listening to it, it evokes such nostalgia. It really makes you feel like the holidays and Christmas time.
I think you're right. I listened to an interview on NPR or someplace with a person, a famous person who shall remain nameless, but who was an atheist. Mm. But ever since he was a child, and the man was in his 50s, he's been attending performances of Messiah because it puts him in somewhat of a holiday spirit, even so.
Yeah, I believe it does. And you have four soloists in this performance. Have you worked with these singers in the past? Are they new to this?
Three I have. The soprano, the mezzo, and the tenor have all sung for me before with us. The tenor has sung Messiah with us before. The baritone is new. He's from Minnesota. It's interesting how these people come to me, I think. I have a connection to the Boston University Tanglewood Institute. Uh-huh. And I hear about 7 or 8 singers every year, these young singers, which is very exciting for me. And my wife, Diana McVeigh, is an opera singer, and so she connects me with singers she sings with all over the country, and so sometimes we use them. And then also, one of our important missions, I think, with the Civic Chorale, we'll be doing our 10th annual collegiate vocal competition, which is open to college students, conservatory students, university students in Connecticut, Massachusetts, and Rhode Island. And sometimes, they serve as soloists in our March concert. Some of them have come back and been our soloists 10 years down the road or 5 years down the road. So that's exciting to watch their careers develop.
Start out as, you know,
a contestant.
Right. And now a professional.
Right.
That's great. And so here's our little flyer here. The Rhode Island Civic Chorale and Orchestra. The performances are going to be this coming Saturday and Sunday. You can find more information at rico.org.
That's R-I-C-C-O.
.org. Ed, thank you so much for being here today. Good luck with your performances.
Pleasure. Thank you.
And everyone, please stick around for the 4 o'clock hour with Kate Nagel. She will be handling, as always, news and politics. And that is my hour. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time.